new product in the market that enables digital video to obtain a film-like look. Here to show us that product, co-founder of Red Giant Software, Sean Seyfried. Hey, Sean.
Hey.
How's it going?
Very good, thanks.
So you have a new product that hasn't hit the market yet. We're going to see it first here on the screensavers.
That's
right. It's called Magic Bullet Editors.
That's right.
So tell me what you have going on here.
So essentially the product is a tool for creating or changing the mood in your video.
Mm-hmm.
And it also gives you the ability to emulate sort of old film damage. So if you want to make it look grainy or scratched up, you can also do that kind of stuff with it. And it's all built on technology that was developed at a post-production company right here in San Francisco.
Oh, nice. So you're taking people that shoot on DV or little mini camcorders, rather than get that camcord-like look, you want to make it look like film.
That's right.
So show me some effects. Let's jump right into it.
Sure. So I'm just going to play this clip real quick. You can see it up here on the screen. And this is untreated, so we're just looking at the base digital video part of it here.
Okay.
Right, so looks like video. You know, we don't have any problems with it. Good shadows, nice balance.
Mm-hmm.
But let's pop forward here to the Magic Bullet segment, and you can see that we've treated it so it's looks very soft.
See.
You got this diffuse look, and it's much warmer in the tone.
This is actually called the warm look, isn't it? The warm
That's
effect.
Right. That's
now,
right.
We have a side-by-side comparison we can take a look at too of this effect. Here it is right here. So we see the original on the left there. I mean, you can definitely, that's what my stuff looks like when I shoot it on Mini DV. And it definitely looks like film quality on the right, doesn't it?
Right, so we've changed the shadows and we've warmed up the image. You can really tell on the keyboard there
how
much definitely. Different the tone is in the two images.
Now, what about the background? It doesn't look quite as clear as it would with, looks a little more, you can see the whites are coming out a lot more than it would.
That's right, because we've added what's called the diffusion filter to the image. Just like if you had put a diffusion filter on your camera when you shot it, we've done that in the post-production process here just by dragging a filter right on the clip.
So what kind of filters do you have? I mean, is it based on the type of camera that, effect that you're looking for, the type of filter that you're looking for? Or a certain style of movie?
Well, there's really three different kinds. There's looks for different kinds of movies we've emulated in our software. There's different kinds of filters that you put on the front of your camera, diffusions or grads they're called,
mm-hmm.
and those are little lenses that go right on the front of your camcorder. Or things that emulate the stocks that a film is transferred to. So if you have bleach bypass kind of operation, we can emulate that, and that's what was actually done on Saving Private Ryan.
I see. So now the second clip actually that you have is of the show open,
right.
And you applied the Neo look, which is like the Matrix type of look and feel.
That's right. So here's the before you can see on the screen, and then the after with the Neo look, and all I did was go to my film looks bin here. This is a set of presets. I can just grab that.
Yeah,
and
we actually have
right
the before
it.
And after shots so that we had them pulled up here a second ago. They were going to show. The Neo look, let's go ahead and roll that now. There we go. So you've applied the effect on the right there.
Yep, that's the Neo look. So essentially what happens in the Matrix, the filmmakers decided to give you a visual cue that you are inside the Matrix by tinting the image sort of green, sort of giving you that feeling of being in the machine.
I see.
And so we've emulated that same kind of treatment right inside the filters, and we've created a preset for you so you can just drag and drop that right on.
Oh, that's
the clip.
Cool. How long does it take to apply something like that? Let's say we had some raw footage, like a 30-second commercial. How long would it take to render? I noticed you have a G5 under the desk right now.
Yeah, that's right. This is a dual 1.8, and on this particular machine, a 30-second spot would probably take about 5 or 6 minutes to render.
Oh, that's not too bad.
No, so it's pretty short amount of time on the newest machines.
Cool. So the final, you actually have one more for us. It's called the Miami look.
That's right. So this look is actually similar to what a lot of filmmakers do when they want to give you a sunset feeling. But they're shooting in a clear day or in a blue sky.
Oh, I see.
And they add a grad or a softening, an orange tint to the top of the image. And that's what we've done right here with this. We've sort of applied a soft glow with an orange tinge to the top of the image.
Right. We have the before and after this one as well. Of actually, you can see the blue awning definitely on the left, the original. And on the right, it definitely appears as though it's a sunset or dusk.
That's right.
That's pretty cool.
So this was actually used in the movie Bad Boys, the Michael Bay films, Crimson Tide, all kinds of different films use this sort of treatment to trick you into thinking that you're looking at a sunset kind of shot.
Nice. So what about, not everyone has Final Cut Pro at home. Any other tools that you're developing this for or any other? So
well,
this is a plug-in, right, for Final Cut?
That's right. This is a set of plugins that comes and installs right inside of Final Cut Pro. Previously had a set of tools for After Effects, only as sort of a high-end post-production tools.
Mm-hmm.
And this is also going to be available on the PC next month for Premiere Pro and for Sony Vegas.
Nice. Awesome. Well, thank you very much. Your website is redgiantsoftware.com. If you want to see a hands-on demo, and you happen to be in Las Vegas this weekend, they'll be at the NAB conference, the National Association of Broadcasters. Thanks, Sean.
All right, thank
Appreciate
you.
It.